Welcome along to the Gary Neville podcast, which today is coming to you from the Etihad Stadium. And I think Gary and I are as shell-shocked as anyone at what we've just seen. How do you begin to explain Manchester City 0, Tottenham 4, Gary?
Yeah, very surprising. I mean, shocked. Spectacular day, spectacular result. Maybe it's a lazy thinking process to go into the international break and thinking, well, OK, City will reset. They'll come back after it and they'll be back to their best, and Pep have got them at it. He's had his obviously contract renewed, which just gives incredible news to not just the players but the fan base and everybody, that success is going to remain at this club for at least another 18 months, 2 years, because that's what he brings. He guarantees it almost. And then you watch that today, the first 10 minutes, I thought City were brilliant. I thought they should have been 2-0 up. Erling Haaland misses chances. But from that moment in, Spurs really were fantastic in different ways. Fantastic in terms of their play in the last part of the first half. Fantastic on the counter-attack in the second half. But also fantastic in their sort of game management, their defending. But from a City perspective, it feels very different. This feels like, I used to say, when you're winning something, something's happening. But when you're sort of on the decline, I hate to use the word decline, but it does feel a little bit like a group of players who, a number of things, two or three things that I'm thinking. The idea of growing slightly old together. The idea of playing the volume of games together and the physical and mental sort of demands of that. And then the third thing is, how many times can you keep going? You know, I played for a manager and a club that kept going, but there were times whereby you just fall over in a certain season. You've won the league three times on the bounce. You've won it twice. You've won doubles. You've won trebles. And you just can't go any further. And you just need that little bit of a... Your shoulders just drop a little bit. And it feels like that's that third thing that's happening here. So you look at those three things, and that's what it feels like right now at this moment in time. A group of players who really have run a million miles. They've been sensational. But they've just sort of, if you like, become a little bit sort of, if you like, punch drunk, a little bit sort of like that, and that's how it feels. Leggy, lacking in energy. Obviously they've lost players as well, and you know, a couple of players missing through injury that are vital players, and I think I sit here tonight with a long way to go thinking this feels different. This feels like, if you're Arsenal, if you're Liverpool, who I think are the two genuine teams that can win the title other than Manchester City, you must not get carried away, but you must feel, hang on a minute, there's no excuses here now, you know, differently. I think I'm looking more at Arsenal with that statement, really, than Liverpool, because I think anybody at the start of the season that would have said Arne Slot would have come in and done what he's done would have said, no, I'm not quite sure that's going to happen. This was Arsenal's season if it wasn't going to be City's. So I think the pressure's really on Arsenal now to step up and go for it. They had a good start today with a 3-0. But for Liverpool, sat there at the top of the league with that back five that they've got with those front players and the options they have, they must be really fancying it now. Big game next week, Liverpool, City. And I know there's only a few points in it. I know there's a long way to go. But it feels like today, if Manchester City were to win the title this season, as I sit here right now, I think it would be Pep Guardiola's greatest Premier League.